Snipe Squad, what are going on, boy? I'm talking about on. Back again, once again, man. It is your boy, Snapper Jones, coming back with a brand new unboxing. This past weekend was super exciting, man. Shout out to everybody that I was encountered with this weekend. SneakerCon ATL was definitely a blast. Y'all can tell from the videos, I wasn't really focused on sneakers like that. It's just always cool when you're able to link up with other YouTube creators, especially like your homies, you know what I'm saying? Your homies back in town, everybody only back in town for a few days. So it was really us just hanging out and just goofing around on camera more than just sneakers. Because even though y'all know I love my shoes, and that's why we're here today for this unboxing, but at the end of the day, man, it's more than life than just about sneakers, you know what I'm saying? So if you haven't watched any of my recent uploads of SneakerCon Atlanta, check it out, man. I will link it one above me, but like I said, you can go in my library or go to my videos, check out my last recent post because it was fire and SneakerCon was amazing. I do have some more news about SneakerCon I'm not gonna drop yet. I think a big part of being a YouTuber is telling your subs about something you can't talk about, if that even makes sense, but it seems like we always do it. But yeah, I can't talk about it right now. But it's going on, boy, you know what I'm saying? This package came in courtesy of the homie Retro Rico. And once again, if you've seen any of my SneakerCon videos, then you probably already know what these are. So without further ado, man, let's get into what this package is. Fire! Man, one thing about this box, though, I don't know who or what the hell was on that UPS truck, but it looked like piss stains is at the bottom of my box. Tupac Poetic Justice stuff going on in the back of the truck. All I know is, hey, look, bruh, you know, when you handling my stuff, handle it with care, you know what I'm saying? I need mine, that's on dog. Now, another thing that y'all know is, I don't have a cool unboxing knife. I use this super safe box cutter because it's all I have, but if y'all know like some of those, I be seeing YouTubers with all types of, it look expensive too, I'ma just say that now. These niggas be having like $3,000 box cutters. I ain't looking for one of those. I'm just looking for something other than this. My Instagram and Twitter is down below in your left-hand corner. If you see like some dope unboxing knives, shoot them my way, you know what I'm saying? I'll use it and shout you out for finding it for me. But until then, so other than me having a pissed-on box, you know what I'm saying? Today is actually going pretty good, man. Hit the gym, ran about 3 miles, and I'm feeling refreshed, but I'm starving. I haven't eaten yet. I had to get this video out first. Let's see what's in the box, you know what I'm saying? And woo, man, I'm not gonna lie. The reason why I made that thumbnail like that is not to be cringy, but just because I've really been waiting a long time for these to drop. Since the first pictures I've seen of these, I knew I was gonna want them. I just didn't know how bad everybody else wanted them, if it makes sense. Don't get me wrong, all my friends and YouTube friends were talking about picking up this shoe, but I still believe that it'll probably be easy to get, and it turns out it was, but it wasn't. Let me open the box. Yeah, we got the Yeezy 700, and you all already know what these are because obviously I have the originals right here, and I'm not Bull RC. I'm not buying 17 pair of the originals because I ain't got it like that. I wish I did, but I don't. This will be the newer colorway, which is pronounced, is it Mauve, whatever. It's these. So the sizing on these is size 12. Little nigga, big feet. I just don't get it. I know dudes that 6'3 and wear 9.5. Anyway, this will be my first time seeing them in hand. Actually, no, I'm lying. I seen these at SneakerCon, but I just didn't see them in my size. We all know that size can really tell and make the shoe, because bigger sizes may be ugly, small sizes always look better. As y'all can see, these are the Yeezy 700. I'ma just call them Moavs, and if I get it wrong, just don't clown me, all right? I'm telling y'all, I don't know how to pronounce the damn name. Anyways, y'all, this is the Yeezy 700 Moav, or Mauve, as y'all wanna say, I don't really know. Like I said, I seen these earlier at SneakerCon on foot, and they look dope, but they were like in a size 9. Y'all can already tell by the size of this shoe, it's huge, but I undressed my first pair. I undressed these at SneakerCon, and I didn't know actually how they was gonna look on foot, but I actually wore them and they felt pretty good, very comfortable. That's the reason why I love the 500s, because they're very comfortable, but the 700 is very comfortable and it fit me right on my foot, even though I'm a short guy. I'm not always able to rock all sneakers because my shoe size is big and I'm so damn short. I'm only 5'10", but like I said, the 700s look good on me and I was excited to pick up this pair. Now, honesty, it is time for honesty, man. Like, let's be honest for a second. Honestly, y'all, this colorway I don't like as much as the first one. So In my opinion, this colorway is better. Now, the reason why I like this color better is because it's a lot brighter. It got like a little bit more to it. If you ask me, I just feel this wave a little bit more. Doesn't mean I don't totally like this. You know what I'm saying? Don't get me wrong. It's a fall sneaker. It got darker colors, you know what I'm saying? But this hint of green can really pop. If you throw this together with a fit, this hint of green can really pop. And to be completely honest, the most hypebeast thing I think I will ever say on this channel is if these weren't Yeezys, I don't know if I would pick up this exact model. The reason why I say that is because even though I like the model, if this was like a shoe made by Puma, I would have let up on the trigger a lot, actually. But it's a Yeezy, you know what I'm saying? I want this Yeezy in my collection. I want to continue to grow my Yeezy collection. And like I say, man, it's Boost material. That has a lot to do with it as well. Boost is only contracted with Adidas. I'm hearing rumors that that's going to be switching over to Puma because the Boost contract is about to be over with Adidas, and whoever wants Boost can pick them up afterwards. But Boost and Yeezy has a lot to do with the reason why I picked up this sneaker, and also the previous experiences of me rocking this at SneakerCon has a lot to do with me rocking this sneaker as well. Now, the story on how I was trying to get these, man, it was me, Unbreakable Kicks, Flight Academy Kicks, and my boy Big Holly. Y'all seen the video we did when we went up to Cumberland Mall to check out the Platinum 1011s. Now, that was Saturday, the day of SneakerCon, and we all know the thieves dropped that same Saturday, and me and Break was super surprised that Yeezy Supply just decided to drop these at like 3 o'clock in the morning that Saturday morning. It was crazy, super random, and they sold out in no time. Later on that day, Adidas had dropped theirs at the usual time, which is like 10 o'clock, and we were online on our phones in a whip, but bruh, like, we was in line forever. Like, it was said waiting in line forever. And y'all know what Adidas, when it says waiting in line, that doesn't even mean you purchase your shoe. You waiting in line to get a chance to purchase your shoe. So we was just like, yo man, F it. You know what I'm saying? Maybe we'll catch them later. It shouldn't be going for more resale that much. There's not too many people that want them. So we just went in the mall and we did the vlog. But once again, my guy Retro Rico came in handy. He walked up to me in the middle of SneakerCon. I didn't even know this nigga was there, to be completely honest. I didn't know where Rico came from. But on dog, he came out of nowhere. He was like, yo, my man, them 700s dropped. You good? I'm like, yo, bro, I didn't hit. Like, I tried to hit him on the app. I tried to hit him on the website. I missed Yeezy Supply. Could you help me out? Could you throw me a pair? Like, what's up? And he did, man. So like I always tell y'all, if y'all need pairs, I'm gonna link him down below because he'll help you out. It's like he helped me out. But like I was saying, man, this pair was, you know, it came to me and I'm happy it did. Now I'm gonna have some people in the comments saying, yo, these shoes are ugly as hell. Why are you talking about these? And honestly, you know what I'm saying? I can understand where you feel like they're ugly at. Don't get me wrong. Like, this is not the prettiest sneaker to look at. But number one, you don't have to wear it. And number two, you know, I like it. You feel me? I feel like I can put this together well with a fit. Once again, if you guys are just starting out your sneaker collection, this is not a sneaker for you. This is a sneaker for people who have a larger sneaker collection because you won't have to wear these every day or you won't have to wear these 4 or 5 times a week. The reason why I say that is because look at this colorway, bro. This colorway is super hard for you to try to mix and match with an everyday fit or a lot of fits throughout the week. This is a shoe you throw on every now and then. You know what I'm saying? You throw it on every now and then. You got the pieces to match up and you step out the crib. If you want an everyday shoe, go ahead and get your Jordan 1 or your Air Force 1 or something like that. That's more your speed. This 700 is not every day, go to school every day, you know what I'm saying, try to wear with every outfit. It's not for that. It's just not. And I do know everybody out there doesn't have the biggest collection. Don't get me wrong, I started off just like y'all. I ain't have it like that, you know what I'm saying? But over time, I built this. So I understand, guys. I completely understand if you don't like this shoe. But your boy Snapper Jones, I'm rocking with these, you know what I'm saying? Now, as y'all know, I usually do a full review and on foot after I do the unboxing. So that's gonna be in my later video. Stay posted on that, because that should be up tomorrow. No later than tomorrow. I pray I can drop it tomorrow. But in bigger news, man, Adidas is just killing this month. Or I should say Yeezy. I'm hearing that the 500 is dropping this month. I'm hearing that my favorite Yeezy of all time, the Zebra, is dropping again November 9th. And you know what I'm saying? I'm excited, bro. And it's supposed to be another Yeezy dropping soon too. The semi-frozen yellow. I don't know the date, but I know that's re-releasing as well. I'm excited, man. I know a lot of guys who already have these sneakers that's re-releasing aren't happy. But dudes like me, man, who miss out on the first chance, it's always good when you can double back and get pairs for retail that you missed out on. I normally don't do this. I normally don't set an amount of likes I would like to get on a video, but I just want to push myself, man. It's November. Y'all know I've been trying to hit 10K before the end of the year since damn near June, man, and I was so far away from 10K. People was looking at me crazy when I said 10K. Now I'm at 7.3. I thank all of my new subscribers, man. You guys, welcome to the Snipe Squad. You know, it's going to be entertaining. It's going to be fun. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you stay tuned when I do the on foot. And yeah, man, that's just about it. The newest unboxing, the newest pair in my collection is the Yeezy 700 Mauves. Damn, I hope I said that right. It is your boy Snapper Jones, and until next time, I appreciate y'all. Hit that subscribe button. Grind to 10K before the end of the year. It's not too late, man. I don't care what y'all say. I don't give a damn if it's December 31st. Before January 1st, I'm still gonna be screaming 10K before the end of the year, man. Never give up on your dreams. Never give up on your goals. I will catch y'all next time. I gotta go edit this video. Gang, gang.